Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to take a closer look at Beautiful Darkness. This is a book I'm probably not going to be able to pronounce the creators, so I'll just show you guys that there. It says on the back here, join Princess Aurora and her friends as they journey to civilization's heart of darkness in a bleak allegory about surviving the human experiences. The sweet faces and bright leaves, delicate watercolours serve to highlight the evil that dwells beneath the story as pettiness and greed, jealousy take over. So, as I said, an interesting book that just really kind of stood out to me. So let's take a closer look at the art and the book itself, and then we can come back and discuss my thoughts. This is a European hardcover. It's slightly oversized, I believe. They all come in a lot of very weird formats for the European books, to be fair. Like, you know, some of the American publishers like to just mix things up and call it an omnibus when it's a trade paperback. So this is actually slightly wider and slightly taller than a sort of regular American trade. So it's not quite so squared off as maybe some of the European books, but it is oversized kind of scale overall. We've got Beautiful Darkness with all these kind of leaves and things and the hand on the front. We've got a nice clean spine with Beautiful Darkness and I believe it's D&Q at the bottom. And then we've got various kind of quotes and synopsis stuff on the back. And it looks a bit kind of darker and kind of deader. The binding lifted up really well, didn't really have any issues there, everything lay out flat. We start with these black end pages with various character designs on them, and then we get a little bit of the characters in the corner here, and then we basically just jump straight into the story itself. Everything starts out quite light, and I'm going to forewarn you now that it does get a little bit kind of darker, relating to kind of like mold and flies and things like that, but the art style still stays quite cute throughout, and it's got that kind of weird balance, and I think that's why they've called it kind of Beautiful Darkness, because the art is consistently beautiful throughout the book, but they're covering quite, I guess, dark or what could be considered kind of disgusting topics. And there's also a lot of death shown throughout the book, which again is somewhat just shown in a quick kind of beautiful moment. Like this quick moment here where one of the characters just simply eats one of the other ones and then that's it. There's no big kind of outcry or, you know, blood or anything like that. And in some ways the darker things, I guess, is actually the personality of the kind of characters in the story. Going into this, I really didn't know what to expect, other than that there was these people that were living in a kind of dead body, and that was pretty much it, and that the art would be kind of nice. So I just kind of went with it and kind of tried the story throughout. There's not a ton of text, there's a lot more, I guess, kind of expressed at times. It's interesting, it kind of feels like a kind of Lord of the Flies story more than a Borrower story to me. It's very dark and dingy in the way that the things are shown. I mean, it's all part of nature, but death is shown just right next to everything, you know, life and beautiful as well. So you've got, you know, flies and rot happening right next to kind of leaves and kind of creatures and what have you. And it's a very interesting experience for a read. It's not necessarily something that you're going to have one straight takeaway from. There's not really a start and end. I mean, there is a story, but there's not really a start and end point of a character arc or kind of progression in that sense. It's very much this one character trying to survive her friends turning on her, but just, you know, why those various things might happen and how those things may kind of come to be and shown in this really beautiful art. So I can't really say much more than that. I hope you guys have enjoyed this closer look. Let me know below if this is a book that you've checked out or you plan on checking out off the back of this video. As always though, guys, thanks for subscribing, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.